Some more for that, but it's too short. Give me money to hire. Put a bit of money on myself, fucking jewelry, you could. I'm sorry, yeah, I'm fine, I did. Hey, you're still a young pup. What do you call that? I'm quite time to enjoy it. I'm tired now, so.
Cook up a barbecue, you know what?
No, I got work anymore now. I haven't got business anymore, you know, I can't deduct it anymore. I'm retired, completely.
No, up here, I'm a son.
Well, yeah, barbecue. No, I have a lot of money. I'm out of money, you know. I sold everything. I moved up the country down the river at Dumfries Beach.
Oh, yeah, past Dublin.
No, in Dublin. You're 2.5 years from Dublin. I didn't find anyone to say Dublin. Behind, I thought Parham was the next one over.
Very important that he makes contact with Yoshiello, just to keep the pressure on Steve. Two shots is just not hard, but game over. Just one shot, just keep himself in the game. Oh wow, he's potted. Oh, and he's on the
blue. Look at this, he's done a Nick Young.
Cracker. He has done a Nick Young from last night, and that's a big shot, and I'll tell you what.
To put yourself on the hill in your first Australian title.
He will punch the table, Lee. No, he gets up very calmly and says sorry to Steve. Well, I'm sorry, mate, but that was a jag, but I'm going to have to cop it. Oh, he could have made that a bit more easier just to, you know, make sure that he'll be all right here.
I think it goes to the top.
Yeah, it does. And
if he's close to straight going up the top, I think that's where I'd be going.
And he is, and this black shot for the Australian title. It's missed. Yeah. Oh, it's gone in. And congratulations to Mick Skerry. He is the 2014 Open Australian champion. And well deserved, beating some very good players along the way.
Turning brown, son. Turning brown.
Ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon and welcome to the Casual Reading Club here in Darwin, Northern Territory. Welcome to all the viewers on the World Wide Web. These championships have been out on the World Wide Web over the last 11 days. It's been done by Cubicle TV, Dan Lynch, and the ABF stream led by Andrew Saltmarsh and Greg Dingle. Please round of applause for our live stream teams. The officials for this tournament director, Doug Percy. Adjudication panel, Greg Dingle and Andrew Sockrush. And the umpire is Gordon Males. All round of applause for the officials. Our first team to enter the arena. Please put your hands together for Victoria. Captain, Fabi Poole, Vice Captain, Nikki McPherson, Carol Hilton, Katrina Delfina, Rhiannon Bolton, Karen Winter. Ladies and gentlemen, Team Victoria. And of course, they've won 6 in a row. They've reached the final by defeating South Australia in the semi, and they have won it 6 times. They've won this championship 6 times. Once again, for Team Victoria. Their opponents, South Australia. They are led by Bethune Juhal, team manager. Linda Harley, captain. Carol Harrison, vice captain. Renata Delahunty, Joy Sullivan, Elise Mabbitt, Taylor Meyer, and Carol Nunn. They finished top of the ladder in the round robin. They were undefeated. However, they made the final by a little hiccup by losing in the semi to Victoria, and then defeating Queensland to make the final. They have won it 10 times. They are the defending champions, South Australia. Ladies and gentlemen, could you all please be upstanding for the national anthem.
Well, Nathan, SA versus Victoria, ladies. What do you reckon?
I reckon it's going to be a pretty tight match, to be honest with you, Iceman.
I don't reckon. I reckon SA got the players, they've got the top liners, finished up in the stats. They've got Linda, who's won the singles. Victoria got Rio, who was runner-up in the singles. Got Joy, got Elise. Got a lot of experience out there.
I really hope so.
And they're the current champions, Nate Dolph.
I'd really hope so, Osman, being a South Australian. But Victoria, you've got a few players that have been overseas lately as well. Got some tough players now. Been in it for a few years. Lindell, got Colby, she did well at the world titles.
Yep.
It'll be closer than you think.
Well, it's interesting, interesting matchup there if Mickey's playing Carol. Vicks have come out. Well, they must be the away team. Is that right, Shane?
Who's away? Yeah, you get the choice these days to be home or away.
Yeah, who's home? I'm tipping that SA are home with the lineup that the Vicks have sent out there. Elise Mabbitt, break off.
Big break while he's coming up. She struck it well.
Well, the Vicks have chosen to be the away team, and they've sent out two of the lesser strongest players, and up against Elise and Carol Nunn. So that's a very interesting choice.
I don't know if I would have went with that choice. Didn't work out too well for the men's team last night. You want to go real strong from the start, I think, and show you that you really want it.
Well, try and get in front and put scoreboard pressure on.
Yeah, exactly right.
Well,
get off there.
Not really a controlled shot there, Nathan. Just
don't think she took her time with that first shot. She just got down and played the shot straight away without thinking about where the white was going to go.
Yeah. Well, of course we're going to see a couple of little errors. We're going to see little errors in our first few frames because they've just got to settle into the match. And as we speak, Carol's gone in off on the other table, so the Vicks have got two shots on both tables.
We'll see how that two players have put up first goes from Osman. If they can get the two wins off the Aussie at South Australians, two good players, could work in their favour.
Well, the other table, there's no. She's got to try and find some advantages, no actual.
I got a message from Big Kev from Victoria. If you were commentating, Big Kev, I don't think you'd be giving us too much.
So she's played a good
big
shot there.
Big shout out to Big Kev. Do love you, mate.
Kale.
I haven't played in the last few years. There's a couple of new ones for me. Kale Hilton, is it?
Yeah. Is that misprint, Carol?
Is it Carol? Sorry, it's a misprint.
Sorry, Carol. It's not a good shot there from Carol. Try to cover the bottom pocket, and it's done that. Left a gap there, but then also missed the shot in the middle pocket. Chance for at least to get some blockage going. You've got to make a decision. Are you going to pop the ball or are you going to try and cover it? But in or over shot and leave a gap is not the ideal situation. You can't.
I think she was in two minds before she played the shot.
Yeah.
So Mickey making her first ones at the table as well on the other side.
Yep. It's really hard to get the cheer going when your players are not at the table. It's like, how do you support when the Vicks are at both tables? It's really hard to get the players up. Two shots to Elise. Well,
I think Elise could take control of the table here.
Well, she's got to take the yellow into the left-hand corner pocket and then try and jam the other yellow into the bottom right-hand corner. Just see what sort of result you get.
She's got to really think about that yellow that's where they're touching the red there.
That's right, in the middle,
yeah. Not leave it to last where you're going to leave yourself stuck. Try and figure out a way where you can get it clear.
Well, let's go on the first plan. Let's get this ball in the hole. Nice shot. A little bit firm. All right, we're done. We just got a wager on this Big Kev.
We're up for that Big Kev, and I reckon the loser has to fly into Adelaide or Melbourne to make this bet we've got going on. We've got a text message from Kev Harvey saying, "Loser shouts, next we're all together. You, Iceman, me and Tails."
good deal.
Yeah, it's a good deal. Either Bar 8 or Empire.
That's it.
Loser has to fly to the other destination. What do you think, Big Kev?
That's a bit extreme.
Come on, Iceman, you only live once.
What's going on up there? Mickey's trying to put this over the hole. Oh, she had another shot there. We missed that foul there, Nathan.
We did.
Oh, she's half. She can just play it and knock it over the hole. That's not too bad from her. She hasn't done much damage.
She's got her other yellow clear, but.
Yeah.
She's also opened up the table for the other lady, too. What's Carol?
Well, how's Carol going to play this? Is she going to try and pop the red and get out and try and force the issue, or is she just going to put this over the hole? Because if you do put that over the hole, it leaves at least very little. She's got like the one yellow on the right hand side. It's going to not really leading anywhere. Put some pressure back on.
Another good shot is to play this one in the middle now that she's playing. Maybe screw back a little bit. And the red that's near the black, you could try and cover the hole over here where her yellow is near the hole.
Or is it worth having a go? If you. Because that red goes, the red near the black goes into the bottom right.
She's played it. It's going to be tough to get down on this red now playing that way.
That's
just true. Gone.
Yep.
I think she had to get rid of the bottom part of the table before.
Chance for Elise. Really, it's just got to be in or over again, doesn't it?
It does, yeah, because it's going to take that hole away from the black.
Yeah. I just think the women play that a little bit different to the men, Nathan. I mean, I know that the guys, you know, you slot that into the bottom left-hand corner and screw over for the one near the black, pop that, and you know, then the shot into the middle and. The guys will be looking at the out, and I hope Elise is looking at the out too. So
do I. It's a pretty big hole down there. You could probably play it with a little bit of top, and run through for that yellow near the black. I think that might go past that red in the middle.
I think she's going to stun it in, Nathan. Oh, well, she played your shot, but
yeah.
Didn't quite get on anything there.
A bit too thick. I would have maybe used the yellow if she's going to go the way that she went for, but. It's going to make it tough now. So I can't see her. It's going to be tough to get on her next yellow, isn't it?
Yeah. Yep. Mum. 30 seconds. That's not a bad shot, Nathan. She pots that yellow into the bottom left-hand corner, gets a thick kiss on the red. She'll stay on that yellow into the middle pocket.
Yep. Just going to try not to hit it too hard.
Oh, she's going to go that way.
I think she's going the wrong way, your ass man. You got to play that yellow near the back.
I think so.
You're laying perfect for that other yellow.
Well,
you do have to watch out for that red guy in the corner, but you wouldn't be hitting it that hard, would you?
Well, she tried to pop that slow, soft, and stay on the yellow, but it wasn't going to happen.
I don't think it was. I think she might be down in a bit of confidence by the last few shots she's played.
Yeah. Let's see what's going on the other table there with Carol. Missed the yellow. Here's Victorian's real first chance of winning the first frame here.
Mickey's been playing for a few years now.
She has, yeah.
And I think she'll take this frame. She's become a very solid player and loves the big time too.
dear. Okay. Well, she got away with that. She covered the yellow in the other corner, in the bottom left corner.
She did. You just got to cue well, don't you? I spin and screw back to this left-hand side rail.
Yeah. There you go, Nikki.
Try and play that yellow in the other middle. Right,
go to the other table there, Dan. Just get a close-up on that other... on Mickey's pot out there. Oh dear. Jumped the white off the table there. It's a little bit low on the white.
Like trying to play it too much, didn't she, Osman?
I'm not too sure
because I haven't really been on the table, Iceman. Is it a fast table or
no? They're slow. They've only just started ironing them for some reason. That's a nice shot.
She's played that very nice.
Yeah, nice positional shot there.
Don't think she'll be missing this one.
She winking at me or you, Nathan?
I think it's me, Iceman. Boy, you were looking good last night.
Oh. Good use of the jaws there by the Victorians.
Only way to play it, Osman. Only way to play it.
Only way. Well, I have to say that that's probably worth double points, that win, was bringing Mickey up to the top there. And the Victorians still got their guns at the back.
They've really thought about it, to be honest with you, Iceman.
Well, Carol's still got two shots here, but she snookered herself.
If Carol had won this, just to win this frame, I think SA would be in a little bit of straw.
A bit early to call that yet, mate.
I just don't like the way that they've played these first two frames, Iceman. They don't look like they've got much confidence. They're not very loud.
Well, like I said, they haven't really had much time at the table to get that cheer going. Maybe they need you over there for a minute.
I can excuse you for a second. They've got to want it, Iceman. They lift your eyes. Lift.
She didn't have two shots.
I thought she had two shots. No, she didn't.
Hang on.
Okay. I don't know what she's upset about, because she's landed pretty well here.
I think they're in a state of confusion. Oh, okay. Oh. She knew what's going on. It's all good. Don't panic, you Victorians. Good shot required, Nathan. Off the jaw.
Need some Iceman queuing here.
Don't know about that.
Solid as
I think
rock.
It's called Jake Stiffer now.
Jake Stiffer. Largest head.
Well, you've got to be aiming at the high jaw on this one, Nathan, to allow the nap roll to take it in.
I think you just came for the middle of the pocket, Iceman.
I don't think so. Oh, nice shot.
I think she went my way, Iceman. She wasn't aiming going for no nap roll.
No, she hit it solid, didn't she? She hit a good pace.
She hit it with good confidence.
Yep.
2-0 to Victoria.
The Kiwi import, the Silver Fern.
Oh, the Kiwi.
Did that very well. Well, we've got the Australian champion at the table against the runner-up, Nathan.
Well, this could be interesting. There'll be a bit of fire in the belly still from today, I think.
Oh, Rhiannon might be after a bit of blood. Oh. Get a bit of revenge.
I'll tell you what, I would be.
Tell you what, you wouldn't have lost.
I would have lifted.
Gotta win it.
It's tough out there. I've got to say though, Iceman, we've got Lyndall Hulley and we've got Renato Delahunty at the table.
Well, they're probably Australia's top five. In the ladies.
At the moment, yeah, they would be. Well, I think they're both in the top three. I think.
Yeah. Can you pick a number two for me?
I can. Colby Paul. Colby Paul.
Colby playing, number two.
Playing some real good pool at the moment.
Not bad pool by Colby.
Not bad. He's got a bit of humour in you there, Iceman. Had a few beers. Look at you go.
shit, bro. Okay, look at this. We've got all the reds at one end, Nathan. And all the yellows at the business end. So, I don't think that's a good sign for Rhiannon.
No, I think doesn't matter whether she pops it or not, does it?
Well, not really.
Either way, like you're saying before, it's got to be in or over that, isn't it? So,
that wasn't very good shot.
She's played for the rail first. She wasn't even going for the pot anyway.
No. Bit hard to see from back here.
My vision's not good at the best of times, Osman.
Nice shot by Rhiannon. Well, she's got an opportunity here. Pop them four balls up there. If she can leave an angle on her last one. Get back in that bottom left-hand corner, put the black in the middle. Not a lot of room, but it's an opportunity.
Yeah, I can't see the black. Where she can go with the black pair?
I think it's over there. I think there's room. The black will go in the middle pocket.
Oh, we got another message from Big Kev. Ask Iceman how the Captain Morgans are going down. Well, I wouldn't let him have Captain Morgan. It's too early for them. For Kev, we're on the super drives.
I did ask for one, but he teared up when I said, come for Captain Morgan. He said, oh, what?
Too early, Iceman. Plenty of them later on.
Never too early for the Captain.
We're on the big boy points.
Nice shot. Now, has she got angle, Nathan?
She's played this out. Pretty nice, to be honest with you. I can't see where that black goes.
Black goes in the middle, but how do you get on it?
Got a bit of a bad angle from here where we're sitting.
Well, she's above it, so... Oh, it's pretty straight, I reckon, by the way she stepped into that. Big break by Colby, but no result. Well, round and potted that ball, but
I'm not sure if it goes anywhere.
No, it's not on any, not from there. Not unless you were playing it.
Not nice, man.
Come on.
Has been.
Come on, Nate, dog.
Retired 21-year-old.
Well, the pressure's squarely back on Renata now to get this, get a tick on the board for the South Australians.
Well, it's Lyndall and Rhiannon's game over there. Lyndall might take control of that table once she gets another shot over here, unless Rhiannon can pull out something nice here.
She may be looking, I was thinking maybe she might be trying to get off the yellow into the corner, but she missed the yellow. I don't think she wanted to put it there.
Just put the black in a nice spot though. I don't know whether she wanted to put it there, but probably the best spot she could have put it.
Easy snooker there for Lyndall. Nice shot by Renata there. Nice long pot. A bit of confidence coming out there, Nate.
Could fire up the team a little bit. They got to get really good behind Renata here, though.
She touched the ball with her hand, just caught a foul on herself. So it's two shots to the Victorians, Nate. Good
nice.
Sportsmanship by Renata, but...
Don't expect anything less from her.
No.
She would always pull herself up in a situation like that. You'd hope everyone would.
It's two shots to Lyndall up there. Looks like she's going to promote them two balls.
Which I don't think I'd be doing, Osman. I'd be playing that yellow in the corner down here. You could use that yellow.
I don't think
that's one of those yellows to knock it out.
I think that's a really good shot. They're all on now. Every ball is makeable. You just got to make the position. And she's the Australian champion, so she's, I don't really think she's going to have a problem with any of these. Mm. She's got backup balls. Oh, that wasn't a great shot. She's just nicked that yellow.
I don't like using my 2 AIs, man. That's my problem.
Well, sometimes it just makes it a little bit easier. Waste your first one on your half one and then move on. So.
It still wasn't a nice shot. You probably agree with you there.
At least you thought of it, which is the important thing, rather than leaving it for last. She's got to be full of confidence after today.
Oh yeah, she'd be raring to be back out there after the win.
Just go to the other table there, Dan.
Dan the man, over there. Dan O'Sullivan from Melbourne. Come on, SA.
Hope you were sitting down then, Kev. And get a shot with Dan's barracking for SA. Good shot from Lindell there.
Victorian sending three messages. Come on, SA. Gotta love that. Shot there.
Yeah, and Colby's just overrun that one there. She tried to get on that yellow in the middle, just overrun it, and now she hasn't got a pot available. So look at all the reds, Nathan. They've got heads on them like mice.
Oh. Boss man, you're on fire today.
Ah, well, I wish I was on fire yesterday. My poor efforts in the teams event.
Next year, Iceman.
It's always next year.
It's always next year. Linda is full of confidence out there. Oh, she's a
yep,
big
and
comment.
And Linda finishes that one up over there and gets the SA boys or SA girls on the board. 2-1 to the Vicks.
Very, very nice out. What does that mean, Big Kev? A dress.
Well, Colby's just played a really good double there. Kept her out alive, but unfortunately just missed out there.
She's made a meal of this frame. Colby's shed two shots and wasn't too hard out there. I think Renata's going to make her pay here.
Well, the red near the blue spot. Where does that go, Nate?
Mice heads.
Mice heads? Well, where's the red go near the blue, like in the blue spot? Where's that going to go?
I think it goes past that yellow ice, man. That yellow's a little bit further back down than you think. So you play the one in the middle now and get on the one near the black. I reckon they're all on.
When you can get just off straight on that red near the black.
You can use the black to...
She's just deceiving with the angles that we're looking at. Yeah. I think she's just going to play a nice little snooker here, mate. Kev's talking in riddles. We don't get it. Well, she left her on that. Left her on that yellow in the middle.
Still plenty of pull to be played in this frame, I think, last man.
Can't disagree with that one, mate. We've got Katrina Defina over there against Taylor, young Taylor Meyer. No one's really got any advantages yet.
Taylor's made the stateside the last few years in a row, is that correct, Iceman?
Yes.
Been practicing too a lot.
Being coached by Mick Delante.
And Katrina.
Two Rangers from way back.
Go the Rangers. I hope they've got sunscreen on out there, it's a bit bright.
All right, that's a good result for Colby. Look at that.
Just played that very nice.
I don't think you've got a plan for that one.
It was well thought out.
Nice little angle. Punch shot down here. Bit of bottom right on this one, mate. Square it up. Most people play this with bottom left. I play this with bottom right. Brings it down square.
His address is the Comics Lounge.
Nice shot. Now here's the test of Nathan. Gonna roll this in? We're gonna slam it in and screw back.
I haven't played on the tables last minute.
Well,
is it a screwback shot?
Looks like she's doing a confident screwback. Nice shot. That's a very nice shot from Colby.
This one.
Well done, Colby. Nice little out there. 3-1 to the Vicks. We should tell her to concentrate harder.
Super drives, please. Prez. Prez Paul Morelli's gonna go and grab us some super drives. He just wanted to mention.
Two super drives, please, Prez. It's hot work behind here.
He's struggling today. He had a few more drinks than he wanted to last night.
And one for Dan, because it's Cue Ball TV. Correct. Lindo Element, captain of the Victorian team. Checking Alfred's rack.
Joy Sullivan, though, she's been around a long time. A lot of experience, Horseman. See what Taylor can find out over there on that other table.
Oh, what are we on over there, Nathan? What's Taylor on? Is she on reds?
Yeah, on the red one. I'm not sure if it goes past there. It looks like it does from here.
I don't think she wanted that by the look on her face.
She hit it too hard anyway, I think, Iceman. Like, I don't think it would have stayed over the hole anyway.
I agree.
SA girls, looks like from these first four frames, they keep potting balls and not looking at the rest of the balls they've got for the frame, putting themselves in a bit of trouble.
Well, you know, see Taylor up there, she's tried to play the plant, red onto the red, but the red down the bottom near the yellow doesn't go anywhere, and maybe she's just trying to be aggressive and get an angle of that one in the middle and try and break it out, but you just like to see some backup. You don't like to see exposed like that, where if you make a mistake, they can clear the table on you.
Or take advantage of the frame.
Yeah, like that, for instance.
Yeah, because it's going to be hard for her to get control back at the table. I think she's going to be waiting for a mistake from Katrina.
Yep.
At the end of this frame.
We've got Joy up here having a... got a chance at getting some control. She's on the yellow. She's got that red and yellow top left that is going to cause a problem for her. So she's got to do something with that early. You know, you just can't leave that ball like that. Why wouldn't you play it now? Double it and push it over there.
Push it over near that other yellow. I was about to say that, Osman. That's a good shot.
You can't just leave dead balls like that. They're controlling balls.
Like I said, now she's looking to pop this ball as well.
Well, I hope not. She's got to put this over a hole.
You could probably pop this ball last, man, and knock that white, that white, run it through, knock that red underneath the yellow.
Yep, yep.
And kill her red, and then you can think about...
That's a good shot. At least she's got it over the hole. Yep. That's a good shot.
Just watching. Find a way to get rid of that yellow up there sometime soon, though.
Yeah. Just watching Katrina there. She just potted the yellow over the top left-hand corner.
She's getting rid of her balls, which I don't know if it's a good idea. Leaving that yellow near that red.
No. Oh, I'm looking here. What's he in off here, Nate?
Top right corner.
Oh, no. Oh, that's a good shot.
Played that well.
Trina's tried to put that over the hole and hit that a bit firm too, I think.
It's very hard to see from an angle.
It is. It's yeah.
Where we're sitting. To see some knowledge that Mick's been passing on to Taylor here. Find a way to get control of the table again.
Bar service has arrived. The Prez.
There's Paul Morelli. Thank you.
Thank you, Prez. Correct. Thank you.
That's not our fault, Prez. You're more than welcome to have a drink.
That Prez is the best team manager I've ever had. He paid me for that, to say that.
Mate, you can room with me in Albury next year. Ace 2, apparently.
Oh.
From Big Kev.
It's an offer I can't refuse.
Might be drinks on you too, you and Tails, though, I think. Big Kev, you'll be happy with that. You can pay for the room as well.
Joy, please move that yellow up the top there. Hope this goes in. Get on that yellow. Well, she has to do it now.
Just nick off of it, and that red will go. That red will go to the bottom rail.
Yep.
And that yellow will stay where that red is.
And get the white down in the bottom right-hand corner. That would be a great shot, wouldn't it?
And she'll have control of both pockets, the top pocket and the, because that'll cover those two reds on the side rail too. There.
Yep.
She hasn't hit it thin enough for us, man.
No. It's all right though. It's all right.
She's got a nice result.
Yeah. Trina up there, she's on the yellow still. She's gonna try and nudge that red and yellow in the middle. No, she's gonna put this over the hole. That's a good shot.
Probably
double the red back down in the right hand corner, I would think. Get some balls back down here, get them back in play.
Buying that way. But she's left on the yellow up the top to knock her out.
Yep.
I would have been trying to nick off down to the bottom rail and put it behind the black and leave the red there. So it's going to be hard for Joy to not pot her yellow, but she's going to be hard for her to get that white up the other end of the table too.
Yep.
Make her go for it, maybe.
Yeah.
Make her think she might have to go for it.
Yeah, that's a good idea. That's a good shot.
Very good shot.
Definitely into on the red in the middle. So. Taylor's played a good shot there. She's given two shots away and pushed the black safe next to the red.
Black, yeah.
Remembering that the red and yellow in the middle at the bottom there are still safe. Katrina's trying to get it out there, so she just missed that kiss on that.
Almost potted her other yellow.
Yeah. So remember, we've got two shots up there. And Lindell trying to pot this, and
very,
I assume.
Very smart shot from Taylor. It's good to see.
Assume she's going to try and cover in the top left-hand corner here, Lindell.
There's a lot of fouls going on here, Ice Man. Katrina's just touched the yellow with her hand, I think.
She did.
There's been a few of them. There's been three of them today.
Yeah.
Already in this match. It's only four frames in.
A
few nerves.
Unlucky for Lindell there. It's just she played a good shot. And
she didn't want to pop that.
No. Needed to cover that yellow. But you know
what? Here's a shot, Ice Man.
But you know what,
George? Cut that one in the middle.
Yeah,
and,
get the red
bottom
out.
Bottom rail and get that red out.
Yep, that's a good plan.
A very attacking shot. Actually, they're 3-1 up. Can,
well, sometimes
she's got a good potting ability too.
Sometimes a captain's got to do that, doesn't they? Got to stand up and play that, play that shot to inspire the team.
I've seen you do that a few times, Ice Man.
Oh, come on, Nathan.
Nice view here from Dan.
Taylor had the two shots. Oh, she's missed it.
Oh, she's missed it completely.
Taylor's given two shots up the top. And now Lindell's given two shots here. Oh, my God.
I think I can't see Joy. She's very solid, Joy. She'll take her time with this two and make sure. She's just going to make sure she plays the first shot nice. Don't snook yourself.
I think it's a foul snooking.
You could be right here, actually.
I think it's a foul snooker, but I don't know if she's noticed.
Oh,
hang on.
Now she's had a look. Yeah.
Hang on. Why are you even looking? Just ask.
Just
and
ask
let it be.
She had a look. She didn't ask.
Oh.
She's got to leave it on the other side.
Oh, it's a good shot.
She's played it well.
Whoa. I think she's still on it, though.
I think that nap you were talking about before made that.
Well, Katrina needed that one, didn't she? She needs two on that black.
It's going to be tough now.
Oh, she's hit it out. Oh, no result, though.
Oh, yeah. Some nice queuing there by Katrina. Get that white to
She's like a little pocket rocket, just has a go at everything, doesn't she?
She's looking at the double here.
Of course, Steve Gray coaches her. She goes out with Steve Gray. The Australian Gray. Masters champion.
I think Steve Gray made the men's team this year, but then chose to play in the Masters, I think. Last man will be using the parallels on this double.
Triple.
Oh,
it's missed it.
Everything was happening in that shot.
Joy. Go South Australia.
By Joy.
Pick it back to 3-2 down.
Cheers to SA there. New Reds.
How many listens we got there, big fella? 77. Oh.
She might have left her on there, Ice Man.
Okay, right.
She got down real quick to play the shot.
She's gone straight in off in the middle pocket.
She got down real quick. She didn't even take her time.
No. That's the pressure of the final, isn't it? Like, playing for the Australian teams event is just, like, so much pressure.
There is a lot of pressure out there.
Brett Rogers enjoying the soup there in the background.
I don't know if it's a soup or something.
Food here has been beautiful.
You must be hungry.
I think I put on about 5 kilos.
I think I had 4 meals yesterday, Ice Man.
Just want to let you know out there that if you really want to watch a individual that might be on the other table, AEBF have their live streaming and they have a close-up of that table. Unfortunately, there's no commentary on there. So if I was you, I'd stick with the Nate Dog and the Iceman so we can tell you what's going on.
The old Nuggety and Iceman.
Oh, you can open up both windows, apparently, yes.
Taylor's done real well this match to take this match. She might take this frame, actually. I'm sorry. She looked dead and gone about 10 minutes ago.
There it is. 3-all, first round.
3-all.
So, like I was saying, you can you can have two screens going with the AEBF on one side and the cue ball TV on the other. Turn the volume down on the AEBF and then you've got it. You've got it made.
Commentary for both tables, but you can see what's going on.
That's
on the
right.
Other table.
You could have better than us. Well, 3-all.
That's first round over because it's.
I tend to think at 3-all, I think the Victorians might have just snuck ahead at 3-all. I know it's even, but the lineup for the next round is going to change, and the top girls are going to be playing against our weaker girls. So you know what I mean, Nathan?
I do know. Yeah, hopefully it can work out the opposite SA, way for SA this time.
The way that lineup, SA should have been probably 4-2 up. You know, with our better girls playing against the weaker ones.
They have got a little win in that first round.
Yeah, I think I really do think that Victorians are just slightly in front. We have our special guest commentator on the side here.
Shane Crisp. Well,
Shane
Crispy Cream. We've got the Crispy Cream on the
Shane
side.
Shane Crisp doing the running around and giving us information.
He hasn't got us a beer yet. We had to get Prez to do that one.
Yeah, no, that's all good. We need a score change here, sir. 3-all on the board. Don't hold the SA short.
Just because you're from Victoria, Dan, doesn't mean you have to throw our frames away.
Thank you, sir.
That looks a bit better now than the last man.
Correct.
Correct, mate. Let's see, it looks like we've got Rihanna from Victoria and Colby up first. Still waiting on the South Australian lineup. We've got Hobbit Foot just rocked up. We've got our JR Chalkhead.
He's come to get our order for the drinks, Nathan.
You can't get into monsoons with sandals on, JR.
It's a nice Hawaiian shirt that you got there.
Yeah, you have to wash your forehead too.
I'm Vietnamese. Is that your lucky shirt?
We got a big shout out to Big Kev. Old Chalkhead's just rocked up.
Really?
A 30-second delay.
He's doing beans.
At least this can fit on our head.
JR, Australian Masters champions.
He did. Oh, the teams they won today,
yeah.
Didn't they? How did JR go in the singles? I didn't.
Runner up
to Steve Gray.
Correct.
Been a lot of Victorian this tournament.
Okay.
Be nice to see a bit of SA right now.
Looks like they brought Carol Harrison in for Carol Nunn.
Yep.
And very experienced Carol. She knows what shot to play. That's Carol's forte. Carol Harrison up against Colby Poole and Rhiannon up against Elise.
Could be interesting. I think Carol's going to try and tie down Colby. Colby's more of a potter, and I think Carol will just try and plug her way through the frame. There's safety there.
Elise is on the yellows here. Carol's got a ball off the break. That's a good start for her. Considering she didn't get a run in the first round.
Yeah. Come out there with a nice break. Put the white ball in the middle of the table too, which is always good.
Looks like she's in a hurry to get out of there. So just straight down on their shots.
So to slow down and take your time a bit more with it.
Well,
think about the shots.
They both wanted them balls to stay over the hole. Mm. One's jawed out, and the other one's gone in. So
I think Rihanna played it. I think she played to pop that ice, man. She's hit it pretty hard. I don't think she was trying to cover that.
Why would you, though?
Because I think she wanted to play that one over the hole.
Okay. Well, that didn't work either.
You're correct, mate. I think Glace has snagged a little win here because she can play that yellow off that red, and even if she pots it, even if she pots it, it's not a bad shot.
No, she's got to pot it. She's got to clear the red white right out of the way. Go you put it over rail. The hole. You don't want Rhiannon playing the red over to the bottom left-hand corner. That's a good shot.
That's right. Still, you wanted to cover a bit more, don't you?
I don't think that was quite possible because the red's so far out.
Carol's come out firing over there. She's popped a few balls, looking pretty confident.
Carol's put the yellow over the hole, and Rihanna really hasn't done a lot down here in that corner. It's given Elise an opportunity to put the yellow up in the top corner.
Yeah, that's the correct shot there. Play that yellow up there.
Yep, and even if she misses, you're not going to leave her on that red in the bottom right-hand corner to cover, so...
You don't want to overplay it, because then...
Well, you don't want to underplay it either, up against the net, because you end up short.
Some nice queuing.
That's a nice pop. It's alright. It's probably,
We should have preferred it over the hole, though.
Absolutely. Well, just got to open up them two yellows that the white stuck next to and try not to leave around in an easy pot.
Yeah, I think she's just got to screw off of it. This man, you can't really play that. You don't really want to leave her on that red. Red down here near that yellow, because then she's going to cover that hole, isn't she? Well, you'd think so. That's what I would be doing if I was on that next red.
Absolutely. Well, she's got to open these up.
Yeah, that's a good shot. I don't think she's left her on that shot. So.
She left her on the red, but it's okay. It's really, she didn't have a lot of options. She couldn't do anything, really.
Carol's looking... pretty good over there.
She's got control, which is Carol's from the old school. She's happy to put a ball over the hole.
Yellow in the middle now, then this one down the bottom left, and use that yellow near the black to knock that black out. I wouldn't be playing it now, I don't reckon.
Well, why are you going to take your backup balls? Why wouldn't you play it now?
Because I don't think it's going to. I don't think she's got the angle.
I think you're right. Well, if you haven't got the angle, then put the thing over the hole.
That's what I'm saying, yeah. She didn't have it. She was a bit straight. She was just playing to pot out. Because you don't want to leave that black for last.
No. At least it's going to open these yellow. No, she's going to pot.
Well, she's worked out alright for her.
Jeez.
She's got a very good result there. She's opened her yellows up.
Wow.
She's got very lucky there. I don't know why she was trying to pot it.
For the speed she hit it, for the yellow to still be there is amazing. She's going to smash this out of here.
Oh, she's opened up Elise's balls too, though.
Well, opportunity here for Elise.
She should go into this with a bit of confidence because Rihanna's got a ball there that just can't go anywhere.
That yellow goes in this corner here. So we've got a yellow in the middle, then that yellow into the bottom right hand corner. The yellow next to the black goes into the bottom right hand corner, so hopefully we can just roll this in like so.
And open it up, a little bit. She's played that. She's from here, we can actually see this angle.
Yeah, it does go.
She's landed nice.
Straight on it. Now she can stun that.
Open the black a little bit.
No. Put it dead straight. Stun it and stay with the yellow on the right, the bottom. Like that.
Oh yeah.
Now we can start looking. Black probably goes into the bottom left-hand corner. from over here, from over the top right. So
me, I'd be trying to, I'd honestly try and promote it so that it's got plenty more holes and takes the pressure off yourself too if you can.
Yeah.
If you, you know your black's got two or three holes rather than one hole it can go in.
A freak like you would take the yellow into the top right-hand corner, freak nudge into the black and nudge it over, it to land somewhere in between the two reds on the right. Then you've got the ball over the hole and just pop, 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 like you do. It'll be over by now. Have you reckon the next set of balls?
Come on. Get the stopwatch out.
Oh, Carol's got two shots on the black over on the other side. I've just been advised by my runner. Oh, lovely shot there by Carol.
It's good to see. She's cut, she didn't play the first round. She's come out and just played a really good frame so far.
Well, so we still have the problem with the black down here. And Carol's got, you know, obviously we know that...
I think Lisa's going your way, Osman. She just doesn't want to promote it.
Let's have a look. Well, Carol, what are you going to do, Carol? Are you going to use that jigger or not? So, we know that jiggers are a little bit harder to use. Let's just have a look at the technique here. Put that down, hold it down solid. That's it. That's good.
It's pretty confident on it.
Elbow up.
She just jabbed at it, didn't she?
Yeah. Had to put it over the hole at least to get the pressure on.
Just missed it by a bit.
So it's squarely back onto Elise to get this tick for the SA girls.
Just going to try and knock it out here.
Oh, it's a nice shot. Kiss the red.
She got a little bit unlucky.
Didn't quite get the result.
Well, it's a do or die here with this frame. All the other reds are...
Up against Rhiannon, so yeah, I'd have to agree with her there. I'd just like to see it sitting near or over a hole if it doesn't go in.
I'd probably be playing
the double
because you get in or over the hole. There's a couple of balls down here. Where
that's right. Get
they
it
might
over.
Need to use that hole.
We've got to keep the pressure on. You can't just blaze away and see we're jacking up here.
She's going for the cut, I think. Oh,
no,
safety.
Well, at least she had some safety in mind.
She did, yeah.
It's not the worst shot. Keeps the pressure on. She really can't control the white off that top rail, off the back rail here.
I think she might leave on this yellow if she gets to this.
She's going to take the second red up. It's a good pot.
No, it's just going to sneak her here, I think.
Yeah, we just probably just have to touch her if she does sneak her.
Just screw behind the other red. Just a bit of stun shot. Just
easy for you to say. Actually, this is probably a better shot. It's easier to screw back like that. That's a very good shot.
And she's taking away that.
No, you just got to sit behind it.
To do now,
would you sit behind it?
You got to hope for the best. Just sit behind that red and give it two shots. It's going to be very hard for Elise to win this frame now, you think.
Yeah.
See what's going on that other table.
We're just waiting for this table. She's waiting for Elise to have her shot. Old Colby.
30 seconds.
Oh, good shot.
Good shot.
Nice shot.
Very well played.
But look at, see the result, Nathan. She's got one shot, but she's got a starter ball. It's exactly the same.
Same, exactly the same.
It's sitting behind. It's sitting behind that red up the top, because she would have had to waste one, and actually had to play a good shot to actually be on the ball.
Exactly right. And
so
the percentages were.
It's really done her no favours unless she potted that ball.
She's played well to hit it, but the percentages are very low.
Yeah.
know if his frame's over yet, Iceman.
I'm thinking there's going to be a few more shots.
Would have tried to leave that white down that other end of the table.
Yeah, I would have liked to have seen
that. Go back up there.
That's right. You don't want to travel too many Ks.
Done a couple this trip.
Stretching here. What's the result going to be? Ooh. See that?
I see, yeah.
Stretching, no good.
Put straight back into Lisa's favour now.
Well, not yet. Rhiannon's got the opportunity to play a good shot to get the safety.
I'd be putting my money on Elise now in this frame.
Well, I tell you what, chip this over the centre pocket and get the white behind the black. Snooker behind that.
She's got to get it though, Iceman.
Something similar to that. Why is there no time taken? Why are they rushing into their shots?
The pressure, Iceman. They're not handling the pressure too well, I don't think.
I mean, she thought of the right shot, but spent no time on it.
Yeah.
It's got to be in or over now.
Has Colby still got two? Did she have two over there?
No, she didn't. Carol just missed the black with the jigger.
So, it's ended up right there for Elise. She's played that not too bad. The hole covered enough. I don't think she can put that red past that yellow. A little bit more over the hole would have been better, though. Or in.
Yeah. Carol, across the table.
You got it, don't you?
Well,
I don't, because even if you hit it, the white's on the bottom rail. She's going to play another nice shot. Colby does.
Yeah, she's got to play a good shot, and I think the red on the right hand middle is just a bit the other side of centre.
What she's looking at is she was looking to put that red on the black, and I don't think you should go that way.
Well, that's not a bad shot for the Victorians.
Can't see the angle again.
I don't think the yellow's on. It's not a bad shot.
I think that'll come off the bottom rail and off the red pretty easy.
Carol has just played a great shot there. Just played a great shot. Nearly potted it out of the snooker.
Push the pressure on Colby here.
Absolutely. I've just had word that the red on the right hand side up the top on the top table is about 2.5 inches past centre. Oh no.
She's overplaying her shots over the holes.
Fortunately, she's gone the middle. Like she's either going to play it off the yellow, but the pot wasn't on the hat. Sorry, play it thick into the red, knock the red up.
That's exactly what I want.
Halfway.
Tough to play any of these shots now.
So where's this yellow going to go? Oh, she's going to miss the yellow. That's a good shot.
She's underplayed. That's not a nice one.
No, it's not a good shot. It's
at
short.
At all. She should have wanted to be right down the table. You want to be in the middle of the table here.
Colby's missed the red in the middle and given Carol the shot at the black.
It was a tough shot. She left it a tough shot. She played a great shot, Carol. This is from 3-1 down to go 4-3 up here if Carol can finish this frame off.
Well, she'll be getting the run the next round.
You'd think so. Well played there by Carol. It's come out strong.
Oh, look at this. Left on the back rail. She's left it on the back rail.
Look out.
What's Elise got in her chalk bag?
I think the tables have turned a little bit on the Vicks there. That plan that they went with at the start of the match.
Well,
it's gone the same way as it did for SA. Their better players have lost their frames.
Yeah. That's a nice shot.
Yeah. She can play sleeper here though, Rihanna. She can. The black.
Yes.
But you know what I'd be trying to do? I'd be trying to get that red up the table a bit too. So
you know what I would do
here? That other end there.
What I would do here is I would try and cut the red over the hole and get the white up the other end of the table so she can't cut that yellow in. Double kissed it. That's half the result really, isn't it?
Gonna need some good cue in here to get the white down there, back down the side of the table.
Well, that is true.
She's gonna take a bit more time than what she's been taking lately.
Well, at least she's having a
good look at
it.
Exactly right. you've got 30 seconds to off spin, and then you've got another 30 seconds.
That's right.
So
that makes about a minute, I reckon.
I don't know. I haven't been counting long.
I would have been playing that with top.
She's
What do you reckon?
She's trying to cover the hole.
Yeah,
she's looking at covering the hole. She's not going. She's not going for the out because that black doesn't go past the red.
No. So she's got to hit this about 3.5 inches away from the jaw. Hit that red solid.
She's going into that shot knowing she's giving Rhiannon another shot, which I wouldn't be doing.
Yeah.
That's giving her another opportunity at the frame.
That's a good shot. That's a good shot.
Quite a good shot, but it's still giving Rhiannon another shot.
Win or lose on the double here, Nath.
I'd love to be in Rhiannon's shoes right now. Because I wouldn't have thought I would have went to the table again after that last one.
Fair call.
She probably thought after her last shot, I'm going to lose this frame, but now she's got another opportunity.
Yep. Oh, what's she got? Jumps up. No, she stayed down. Stayed down on that. Played it beautifully.
Exactly what I was talking about, Iceman.
For all. Great effort.
Toilet break. Toilet broke.
Guilty. Made more room for the beer.
Yeah. Lost a couple of kilos. Both Victorians at the table again. She's giving two shots away there, trying to cover the hole. I don't know if she's covered it though.
No, I don't think she has. I think it's a foul snooker.
Yeah, just heard foul snooker, yeah.
Yes, so she's going to pop that red over the hole. Lindell will. Lindell Morford.
Just see someone's thinking out there.
Okie dokie, let's get back on the program here.
Let's go with Lyndall Morford, I think.
Hully. Lyndall Hully, yeah.
It's Hully.
Yeah.
30 seconds. Yeah,
correct, mate.
She's on the reds, bro. So Lyndall up there, Lyndall Hully has got a lot of control up there. She's got the yellow at the bottom left and yellow at top right.
She's still got two as well?
I don't know.
She must have
to
if she's going to play.
Don't think so.
She wants to keep control of that pocket down there.
Well, Chris, the Captain Morgans will be flowing after I finish my next beer. I'm just trying to keep Nathan Neames happy. He's soaked up when I ordered a Captain before.
The beers aren't flowing as fast as they were this morning, so there might be a change up soon.
Well, she's played a very good shot there, just opened them all up.
She's full of confidence out there at the moment, isn't she, Lyndall?
Yeah. Why wouldn't you be?
Exactly right.
Nice shot from Renata. How's that shot there, Nathan?
It's good to see from the SA team if you're sitting on the sidelines. Two best players out there going for it.
Well, I think Renata should be playing that red down the side rail there. That's a worse ball. If she misses this, she's going to be a shot behind. She's got to get her dead red off as quickly as possible. See now.
Hasn't ended up too bad. But
she's got half a result because she hasn't left her on that dead yellow up the top or an easy pop.
If it would have been knocked, if it went in, that would have been awesome. She could have played that red down the rail, left it over in or over.
And that's where we were a shot ago. Exactly the ball sitting in the middle of the table is not a problem. It's just a ball you can use if you need it. It's not a hindrance.
Yeah. That's true. Hindrance.
Yeah. It's on your side.
I don't know what that means, eh, Alice, man?
Come on, bro.
Oh, Buffer's back in the room.
Trying to fire up the SA chicks. Interesting choice of shot here. It's a good shot. It's a good pace.
She's played that well.
Got to play that red up the rail.
You know
Katrina's
what?
Trying to get her balls out of that dead corner on the bottom left there. And she's under a lot of pressure here. One miss would leave it open table for Lyndall. Tried to cover and left a gap up there, I reckon. And Renata's given two shots. Oh, I don't know about that shot.
I was looking at that shot and I'm looking at your shot.
Can you please just take the dead red off the rail?
You don't need to play that yellow because
we don't need that
the
pocket.
Red, you don't need that pocket.
We don't need that pocket.
You got to play that red down there.
There's five other pockets there, Nate.
That's correct. There's only six pockets and that one was covered.
While that red's on that side rail, there's not enough pressure being applied. And it's all about pressure.
It is tough out there.
You've got to want it.
You've got to need it.
Well, that's blocked.
That's a pretty good shot.
Let's block the red up, but I have been told that the two reds at the top on the bulk line do actually plant into the top left-hand corner.
what I'd be doing is, because I'm not sure if that yellow is on the sit right on the bottom rail up there. Whether she can.
What do you mean if it's on? Is this one here?
Is it sitting on the actual bottom rail, fat on the rail or not?
I don't think it's on. I think it's about probably an inch off. Yellow going. Does that yellow go in this corner?
I think Lindell just jumped up on a shot a little bit there.
It does. So the yellow next to the black does go into the bottom right hand corner. Thanks to Charlie for letting me know that. Because Lindell's actually looking.
Can always rely on Charlie.
Lindell's actually looking at the out here. Play this with a bit of right hand side. Top right, put the yellow in the middle pocket. No,
it's going to cover. A bit of coverage.
Well,
I don't think Ronaldo will be playing that red up that bottom corner of this storm again.
Well, you tell me what she's going to do then. Bunts.
She's got it. Is it?
Come on. What's she going to do?
I've got 30 seconds, right? And then they'll call that. And then I've got another 30 seconds. Okay. So I've got a minute to think about this. Just give me a sec.
Yeah, you're just waiting to see what she does. Well, it's the same thing.
She's in a bit of strife, mate.
I'm telling you, it's the same thing. You've got to get that dead red off the side rail. Leave the white up the top here.
Leave the white up the top.
Chris, I reckon he's getting soft too.
Who?
Chris Ormsby reckons you're getting soft.
Oh, I haven't got any confidence. I haven't played for a while. Chris,
no confidence, bro. That's a good shot by Renato. Because if Colby wants to continue on, she needs to pot. Sorry, if Linda wants to continue on, she needs to pot that red at the yellow in the top left-hand corner, which will then make the plant back on. Plant with the two reds. If not, then Renata still has an opportunity to finish the frame, to pot out with all the balls going into the top right-hand corner.
I was going to say, I don't think she's going to play that one over the hole. But we still don't need that pocket up there.
Well, we do, because that plant
that
does
go. We need that one.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? You can probably play this red in the middle here. Move the yellow to the bottom rail, and then I reckon those reds might go past that yellow.
Well, the low one. I think the higher one will certainly go in.
It's got another couple of pockets in the middle, though. You can play that one.
Yep. Katrina up there is.
How's your beer going down? Mine's going down like razor blades.
Prefer a captain. She missed the yellow there. Renata
tried to hit it in the middle of the red, but Katrina looks
I'll
like
tell
she's
you
going
what.
Out up there. She's not much slowing down for me.
Oh my God! Too much excitement going on. Katrina needed had kittens.
Rose fell into the crowd then.
She just beat the Australian singles champion.
She was pretty excited about it.
Absolutely.
I don't know about that.
Well, have a chance here for Lindell.
This match is up and down like a yo-yo, Osman.
That'll be Chickpool.
Chickpool. ABC okay. Out here, isn't it, really?
Well, the trick is here. Well,
where's the black? She's got to get on the black.
That's the trick. The black is the trick.
This is where she's got to slow down and make sure that she's going to leave herself positioned to get on the, pot that yellow and get on the black. Make it easy for herself. Rather than getting down, leaving it down there and going, I didn't leave myself positioned to get on that black.
Well, obviously, the black in the right hand centre. If it goes, I don't know if it goes. I can't see from here.
I don't reckon it does. Honestly,
I don't know what this is. It's here, bottom right.
She's gone pretty far. Yeah.
Why? Stand like why people lift their right heel off the floor. It should be like stable on the ground. She was only playing the screw shot. It's not like she had the jack up. She wasn't on the cushion. But it's just not a stable base to work with on from the floor.
So try to hit the head off of that one.
Oh, you know what? It's actually worked out perfect for her because she's going to pot that in the middle pocket. Miss the red up the top rail off the side and come back for the black in the bottom left-hand corner.
I don't even think it'll come off the side rail. I think it'll just come straight through between the red and the black.
Between the red and the black? No.
I don't think it'll...
Oh, she's going to screw off it. Well, in that case.
Here we go. This
and then it's going to come back on another one. That's what I said.
She's played... Yeah, I think she's actually not landed too bad here.
Tell you what.
Considering it's close,
I reckon you'd pot that.
Oh, it's I've gone soft. I think I might play safety.
I've been told it's aiming at about an inch up the rail. It's aimed high at an inch up the rail.
She needs to be good with her cueing here. Cause you
high
don't
or know. Low? Low. I've been misadvised.
You don't want to double hit the white here.
Yep. So she needs to cut this pretty fine.
It's gonna be
stretching. And potting.
A little over it.
6-4 to the Vicks. Well. Wish Renata played that red up the side rail a little bit earlier. It's just
might have made
not
a
putting
difference.
Any pressure on.
We got Mickey and Taylor over there.
Six, four, and I am in shock.
Yeah. Frames haven't been very good to watch. They've been just a lot of just get down and hit the ball. They don't want to get off. It looks like they just want to run away from the table every time they play a short.
You've got to own the table like you do, Nate. You've got to make some table presence.
Get
like
in there.
The man is here. Get out the way.
You got to want it.
I think that must be paying Brett Rogers to sit and watch the ladies.
Yeah. I've
Is that right, Dan? They're paying him to watch. He loves the game, doesn't he, Brett?
He might be trying to put a bit more fire in the belly for his match tonight.
Yeah.
Wants to be out there already. Can't wait.
If you don't know Brett Rogers.
How do you think that match is going to go tonight, last week?
Tonight,
South Wales and Victoria.
Tonight is going to be a boomer.
Boomer of a night,
you know, I've been playing at the Nationals for 28 years, and I have never barracked for Victoria in the final. But tonight, I am barracking for Victoria.
I was about to say the exact same thing. I'm not going to put the big V on me, but I'll go for him.
No, I can't go blue, but...
I don't look good in blue. Well, actually, it brings my eyes out sometimes, but...
Nathan, don't look at me. I go weak at the knees. But I want Victoria to win.
Yeah, I don't know if anyone from New South Wales team... I don't know if they live in New South Wales, do they?
Well, I think Damo does, and he's a team manager.
Team manager,
does that count?
Yeah. I think when New South Wales hold their next Nationals, I think they'll be paying more flights than anyone else from any other states.
That's right.
cracker of a match tonight, though.
Well, you know, in one team, you've got four players that finished top four in the stats with the Victorian team. You've got Australian players in there. You've got Australian players representing New South Wales. You've got Australian champions in Kurt Dunham and Rusty Wheeler representing New South Wales. I'm trying to find my book. Hang on.
I think we've got some. What Victoria have in there?
Jake McCartney. Jake McCartney is Australian champion.
I think what they've got in their favour, the Victorians, is they all play together. They practice together. They've been doing this together for years, whereas New South Wales are only new together.
New? I don't think they're new. Travis Crawley has been there for years. Stevie Woods has played with Travis for a few years. Brent Reed played with him for the last couple of years. VJ Randall is new. He's from Queensland, but he's been to the world titles.
Justin's new with him.
Justin's new with him. Another Australian champion, Stevie Woods, runner-up twice in the Australian titles.
I don't think Craig Stevens made it over.
No.
Sure.
Barry Kitchener, Australian team player this year, current.
They're not new players. I'm just saying I don't think they play much pool together. Whereas in a team's event.
Yep.
Which has proved over a period of years, is you got to gel and you got
to. Well, what we're trying to judge here is who is the best team, and team means.
Is when you want to be there together the and you stick together and you cheer together and doesn't matter what happens, you're a team. It's not you. It's not you out there. It's your team.
That's right, and it's very easy to play for South Australia or the Big V, but when they travel from Brisbane or Queensland to play for the Blues, how is that from the heart? How is that from the gut? You know, you're representing New South Wales, but you're not from there. You don't live there.
Yeah.
How does that work?
Whereas this is where this comes in. Like, you've got people in Victoria that have taken days off work to watch and to watch the, because they love their team because they all stick together.
That's right. So
it'll still be a very good match tonight.
The quality is going to be fantastic.
As we saw there last night, 16-16 or something.
You had to go into deciding
race to four.
That's right. We were all hoping that Victoria would have beaten New South Wales, so then South Australia was hopefully going to put out New South Wales, so they didn't even make the grand final and not even give them a chance to win it. But now we've mucked that up and we've given Victoria the opportunity to knock them out in the final. So, you got to tell, you know, all the people listening out there, you got to tell your friends that this match is on tonight because it's going to be one of the best matches you've ever seen. Quality, just high quality.
There's going to be a lot of outs, and there's going to be a lot of good outs too. Yep.
And you know what? You're going to see some balls being missed from the amount, just so much pressure.
And if you're in Darwin, and you love your pool, and you're watching this, I think you should come down and have a look.
Absolutely.
Because you're not gonna regret it.
No. And Darwin won't see anything like this for another 7 or 8 years, so.
No, that's for sure.
If you take a drive and get down here, why wouldn't you?
And they might not even get it in Darwin either. It might go to Alice Springs. It might be somewhere else.
True.
Could be a long time yet.
Hasn't Jake's won a single, hasn't he? Hasn't won it. Well, I have been corrected. Yeah. Okay, one single.
Now, when did you say he'd won a single?
I was talking anyway.
No, Jake hasn't won a single.
Oh, I thought Jake
had
won.
The only thing he hasn't won.
Okay.
I said to him last night, I said, when we're out at Monsoons, I said, if it was race to three, Black Caviar would have put a bet on you.
Jake is a star. He's a great player.
He's got plenty of years to win one, and I'm sure he will. There's a lot of good players.
Well, that's what they said about James Delahunty winning Berry, but he hasn't won that yet.
The old quarter final specialist.
That's the one. Anyway, what's been happening over here?
We'll get back to the women's pool. Just revenue's all up for the men's match tonight as well. So everyone get down if you can. We're going to get back to the women's pool now.
Okay. Well, we've got a bit of a pack up there with Taylor. A couple of reds, a couple of yellows. Don't know what we're on.
Mickey's on the reds.
That's a foul snooker. Taylor's on reds. And she's nominated the yellow.
Just get rid of the... Yeah, that's a good shot. That's a good shot.
Get them out. And Mickey's on reds. Played a good shot. So Mickey's got a chance to clear up here.
I think she's going to find it hard to land in the middle of that table.
Off this shot.
Off this shot, because you're going to have to land in the middle. Because you don't want to be in the white. You don't want to land short.
No.
You're not going to be able to hold for that last red.
Can play this off the rail first. A little bit of left hand side. Use the side rail to just get up a little bit.
But the table's got a bit of pace on them, like.
No, the table's, they run average. I wouldn't say they're fast.
Just going to have to give it a little bit of pace. So this is what I was saying. Don't know whether she's.
I think it's not too bad, Nate. I think it's okay. Yeah, she can cheat the pocket.
She can underplay it though.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You can give two shots back here. Oh. Carol Hilton's at the table on the other side. I'm not sure if that yellow goes in that. She's playing the other one. Didn't realise she was on that.
You can hear a pin drop in here. So quiet. Well, she didn't think she could hold it, and she's knocked it safe.
That's what I was saying. She didn't want to land short like she did.
No.
Another
probably
one.
Just need a bit of top right on that last one, just to square
she
it up.
I think she still hit it way too hard anyway, to try and hold for it anyway.
Well, if she had played the top right, it might have been okay.
What she was trying to do was come off the bottom rail and land on it.
Yep.
And she's hit it a million miles an hour, she wasn't going to land on it anyway.
Well, if she hit one of them two yellows that are stuck together, it would have left her on it.
You're still hoping for a little bit of hope, because you've got to hit the one on the rail and, and snook it yourself.
Yep. True. Face double here. Off the yellow maybe even. Straight in.
Big hit. That's a great shot.
Sweet as a nut.
Someone's got some confidence out there. I used to be able to play shots like that at Osman. I don't know about it anymore.
Oh, riding the bike, Nate Gold.
It's got to get back on there.
That's it.
Taylor's back at the table on the other side.
She's bridging over the yellow, but I don't think she can do a lot.
I want to see her, what I saw last frame, she had a real think about it and try to take control of the frame again. She's got a couple of dead balls in the middle there. That's a good shot. She just put that yellow on the bottom rail.
Yep. Ooh, oh, nice black. Nice black. That white was going into that corner there, but just clipped that yellow.
It's a big out by Mickey.
7-4. Three games start.
It's a very, very big out.
I think the South Australians are in a state of shock.
I really need Taylor to win this frame here. Just get that margin back a bit.
4, 12, 13.
Carol's going to try and cut this across.
Guys, out there, I think I need to depart. because I think the ladies need my help.
Need a little bit of a cheer.
I think they do. So
if we get, we're not going to have a bit of a cheer. If it gets close again, we'll come back and have a little bit of a...
Yep. See what we can do out there.
I'll see you back soon.
We'll see if we can send someone over.
Come on, Taylor. Come on, sweetie. Come on. Come on.
Come on.
Come on,
Taylor.
Come on, you want that? Oh, Taylor.
Come on, you want that?
Oh, Taylor.
Come on.
Come on.
30 seconds.
Come on, Carol. Come on, Kaz. Come on, Carol. Come on, Mickey.
30 seconds.
Come on, mate.
Come on, Mickey!
Come on, Mickey!
Come on,
Mickey! Come on, Paris! Come on, mate! Come on, buddy!
1 second,
Eddie! Come on, mate! Come on, mate!
Even though I didn't rank top, not the French,
30 seconds.
Yeah, great shot. Come on, 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 come on Elise.
Great shot, up!
Come on, Elise.
Thank you.
Come on,
Come on,
Seconds. Yellow balls in play.
Joe Fanto coming to you from the Casuarina Club in the Darwin Northern Territory. We're live streaming to the world. It's the Australian National Titles. Australian Eight Ball Federation National Titles for 2014. This has come to the culmination. We're halfway through the ladies event. Ladies teams, South Australia and Victoria. And of course, this evening, later on in about 8 o'clock our time, which is still another hour and three quarters. There will be the men's event, which promises to be another great match between New South Wales and Victoria. In the meantime, it's business here between Vics and Victoria and South Australian ladies. Great rivals of the past. They've won numerous championships. South Australia has won about 10 of these championships, and 6 to the Victorians. It's not a bad shot by Taylor. Wendell Element now has got her work cut out to try and work out how she's going to get herself in a winning position with those reds in the middle. Victoria's taken a narrow lead after being up three or four frames and South Australia fighting back. So we've got two Victorians at the table at the moment. It's a nice pop by Lyndall Element. Still got lots of work to do though, the way these reds are spaced out and clustered in the middle of the table. But she's a great player. So Victoria just picked up another one. So Victoria 9-7 now.
30 seconds.
Lyndall's taking her time. She must be getting close into the last part of her 30 seconds. Slowly but surely, they say. See what she can work out to pot and promote these yellows. She looks a little bit too straight to be able to work the white to do anything with that ball that's clustered in the middle there. You never know what these players can pull out sometimes with a little bit of spin and cushion and make that white ball go in all sorts of directions.
30 seconds.
Trying too hard with the white to get the white ball across and hence miss the pot. That lets young Taylor in to see what she can do to retake control of this frame. It's a little bit of a stalemate at the moment while those three, four balls are clustered in the middle there with the black, the yellow and the two reds. So she's just going to promote this one down the rail or pot it if what they say in or over. A percentage shot. This may be an opportunity for Lyndall Element to pot a yellow here and break those four balls, but it could be a little bit risky because if you miss, then it's all open for Taylor. Missed the pot, but she may have gotten lucky here, and she's probably left a really fine cut for Taylor, but don't know that she'll take it on. Difficult to see if she's got the angle to be able to really fine cut that red into this top pocket.
Come on, Gil.
Come on, Katrina. Good effort. Oh. Got a little bit lucky there. Let's see if she can make the most of it now. She plays her got an opportunity now to go game, but it's not easy. They all look like they're there, but it looks like an easy pot, but she's got to get herself back down here so that she can pot that line of reds.
Come on, Taylor.
Still, Seems to have left herself enough angle to get across, yeah. Looks like it's coming across nicely. In fact, it's perfect. Joy Sullivan's on that top table. South Australia. Let's watch Taylor now. Oh. She wouldn't be happy with that. She had a great opportunity there to get SA back in within a frame. But again, she's got a bit of a lucky lie with the white because doesn't look like Yudu can pot here. Unless it's a very difficult cannon. So she'll be looking to promote a ball and maybe go safe somewhere.
30 seconds.
Unless this runs fast, but I don't think so. Yeah, that's about the best she could do here, there. Probably would have liked it a little bit closer to the pocket. These finals get rather tense when they get to this stage. In a race to 13 frames. Yes, you tend to try and not look at the scoreboard and just concentrate on one shot at a time. Try and keep those nerves at bay and the gremlins out of the mind. Keep that smooth flowing. Queuing action. Lang Taylor looks quite cool. That's a great shot. Beautiful shot. Now she's given herself a real opportunity. Spotted that ball perfectly off the cushion to cannon off the yellow and into the pocket. Clear the pocket. Now she's just going to play a controlled shot and stay on that red. Finished up perfect, but unfortunately, when concentrating on getting in the position, you tend to miss those, even the easiest of pots. And of course, we talked about the pressure that there is in these matches when you're playing for your team. You don't want to let anybody down. It can get quite tense.
30 seconds.
No little element of Victoria. All of a sudden she sees herself with the opportunity. She's played safety. Didn't fancy it in the middle, so she's gone safe and looking for a better opportunity. Can go off the cushion and try and get that red as close to the pocket as possible. But unfortunately, she'll still leave Lindell on this yellow on the rail, which she'll be able to run down and get onto another yellow in the middle of the table. Those yellows close to the black. Joy is still, Joy Sullivan battling away over there on that second table. Yeah. She hit the ball, but it's not the result she was looking for. So that takes a little bit of pressure off Linda as she goes for this ball in the top pocket here. Always makes it a little bit easier with the queuing action when you've got a little bit of relief from pressure, knowing that you don't have a ball over the pocket for the opponent. Looking at the next ball and whether that yellow runs past the black. nice putt. Well, she has the option on the yellow to the right of the black to put in the middle. The problem is to hold the white. To either pot this yellow back here, otherwise she's got to run herself through to try and get onto that yellow in the middle. Seven Victoria.
30 seconds.
And she's just finished a little bit short, even though it's still very potable in the top right hand pocket. But she'll need to try and get her white back across to fit between the black and the red to get on this yellow. It's yellow up this end of the table. Looks like there's plenty of room, but never easy to play those shots. It's going to be stretching out for the bridge. You can see how she controls the shot. Might be on it. Looking a little bit too hard to be on it. Maybe she's it's just gone a fraction far. But the idea was certainly there. Just need a little bit of luck to finish a little bit left of where it's finished. We've got Katrina Delfino at the table at the moment at the top there for Victoria. This match is really very delicately poised at the moment. I think that South Australia need to get the next frame in order to sort of build a bit of confidence once they get past that 10 frame score mark. Yeah, it's not a bad result. But of course, it leaves Taylor the opportunity to run that red down the rail and cover this pocket. Cover the pocket down here at the top. Corner pocket.
Yes, mate, come on. 30 seconds.
Okay. And of course, if it pots, she's got the opportunity to pot the other red. And which she has. Just come a little bit too fast, so it's left herself a double. I think it's at that stage in the match where shots like these that win matches, and if she can pull this off, give herself a nice straight black. Or is she looking safety?
30 seconds.
Just pondering over it, weighing up the probabilities. What's best for the team, and what's best for the confidence she's feeling at the moment, which shot she's feeling most confident with. Oh, she took the gamble, and this really opens it up now for Lindell. You wouldn't expect Lindell to miss the pot out from here. Lindell Element, great player over the years, represented Australia numerous times. Just trying to seize up to control that right to get position. Okay, she's wanted to wait, but she's got better position so that she could hold the. She obviously couldn't hold the white and decided that was a better way to go. It's going to be very difficult to. For Taylor to leave her safe off that ball.
Come on, Taylor.
So she expects to get another opportunity at it. So Taylor's got to pull a rabbit out of a hat here, I'd say.
30 seconds.
Unless she can.
Come on, skip it.
Well, I guess picture tells 1,000 words. That's left Linda the easy pot. And she should leave herself a comfortable black to run down into this bottom right hand pocket. Which will give Victoria a 3-game break if she can make this. She's done it. It's 10-7 to Victoria. And could that be the break which takes them to the to another championship and help them stem a little bit closer to the number of championships won by these ladies who seem to have commanded this competition most of the years. South Australia and Victoria are very strong sides in the game of eight ball in Australia, both in the men's and the ladies. They've enjoyed many a tussle in that old South Australia-Victorian rivalry. Looking at Delfina just hiding behind Gordon Males, the referee, or as we call them in Australia, umpire, but if on the other side of the world, you know them as referees. She's apologised for that one. Let's see what Joy can do here. There's a lot of pressure on her now with South Australia down 7-10 in a race to 13. She knows that in any additional lost frames and it's going to be a big mountain to climb to come back. A delicate shot, see where she finishes. It's a great result. She's prevented the black from being potted and she's covered the pot.
Nice touch, Joy.
Yeah, wonderful touch. Joy's been around a long time. One of Australia's seasoned campaigners, represented Australia many times. Won several Australian titles. And a wonderful team person.
Come on, Ben.
Come on, Joy.
Not quite what she was planning. Now it's up to Joy. See what she can do here. She may have to try and pot this yellow to run up the table and back to put the black in the same pocket. No, she can get bottom on it. Yeah. Come back. Playing with bottom. I think she was trying to get behind the black so she could put it into the same pocket. Instead, she's left with a very gettable pot, but it's always a bit nervy when you've got to pot the black the length of the table and you've got the cushion to bridge over, which adds to the degree of difficulty. But she's played that beautifully. She's kept South Australia in the match. South Australia creeps up to 8-2, just two frames in it. Hope you're all enjoying this, viewers out there, both in Australia and on the other side of the world. This is Joe Fanto coming to you from the Casuarina Club in Darwin, Northern Territory, for Cueball TV. Of course, our sponsors, Consolidated Leisure and Sports, been great sponsors to the Australian Eight Ball Federation for many, many years, in excess of 20 years. Promoters of, under the brand name Mitchell, they promote the Aramuth balls, strong cloth, and of course the True Line tables that you see here that we're playing on for these championships. There we are, True Line, the traditional, under the brand name Mitchell and Aramuth balls. the umpires or referees, as you call them over there in the other side of the world. They brush and iron the tables in between rounds. Or well, maybe not iron. We've got Gordon Miles there on the table on the right. Maybe. Okay, this could be the telling round. 18 frames down, of course. It is only 6 frames to go. So this will tell the tale. Last year we had a draw in this match. And of course, if it is a draw, we go into a 5-frame playoff. And yes, Toby Poole's got what she wanted. The ball off the break and a nice spread. I'd say she'll probably take reds. Pool of Victoria, which was runner-up in the women's singles last year, and went away and represented Australia and England at the World Championships. Of course, tomorrow the Australian team will be selected from these Australian Championships, and Australia sends a large contingent across to the UK for the World Championships each year in Blackpool. Great supporter of the World 8 Ball Pool Federation. A member since inception, back in 1992 when it all started in Perth, when Australia, New Zealand and England met and formed the world body. Let's concentrate on Kobe here. She full of concentration. She did pick the reds, but just missed the pot there. This gives a great opportunity to Elise Mabbott, another wonderful ambassador to Australian 8 Ball. Has won some 4 or 5 singles titles. Represent Australia numerous times. Always a really steady player. You can always expect to get the most out of Elise and very reliable. Yeah, she's come back nicely on the yellow for the middle. Just got one difficult ball that she's got to try and promote, that yellow that's sitting just to the right of the red, the far red on the right here. It's up against the cushion. Nicely working her way through here. So we've got Rhiannon on the other table. That's a nice way to promote that red right into the pocket. That yellow right into the pocket. She was certainly ahead of me. She had that all planned, I would say. So now she's just got to keep her concentration and methodically clear these 3 yellows now. But she doesn't like that because she's in a position which has left a fairly difficult pot in order for her to keep this break going. And she's got an awkward bridge if she takes that yellow to the top left of the screen. It should be hard to control the white. Although she may just be able to roll and take a slight angle to the right and leave herself on this yellow back to this right pocket, the near end here, in the corner pocket. Looks like what she's playing. She's played that beautifully. It's a great shot. Wonderful shot under pressure. It gives herself a great opportunity to still resurrect this break, and if she pots equally well on this yellow, she should be on the on that last yellow to the middle and run through for the black back in this top left pocket. Yes, that's nicely done. All running to plan here. And she's left a nice angle to, would have liked to have been a little bit further left, but should be able to hold that white to be able to bring that black back.
Captain Ninja. Come on, Rio.
Nothing fancy required here. She obviously had different ideas to me. Must have been more difficult than the angles could be, than I could tell from the angles on the screen. And now this is possibly runs past the red in the middle. Put down the end.
30 seconds.
Let's let Elise decide. No, it wasn't there. He just touched the cushion. Prevented the foul. Of course, we know that on every shot, a ball must touch the cushion. Either the cue ball, object ball, must touch the cushion for a legal shot. So Colby Ball has another life, and she can do things like this. Put Elise under a little bit of pressure, lay a little snooker and see what happens from here. Elise now has to just play for survival and hope for an error somewhere by Colby. The 2014 National Women's 8-Ball Championships is starting to come to the business end of the final. Two frames in it between Victoria and South Australia. Victoria lead at present, 10-8. And Elise is in full concentration here, trying to work out what defensive shot she can pull out to survive in this frame. I think we heard the umpires there call foul. Tried to leave Colby in a difficult position, but she has left her on a pot in the middle, even though there's an awkward ridge. She's having a good look at it. You can never underestimate any shot in this game. We've seen some of the players, and I'm sure all of you viewers out there at some stage I thought have taken a shot too lightly and missed the easiest of shots. Yes. She's got past that hurdle. But wasn't able to do too much work with the white. Hence. Leaving herself pots which are harder than what she would have liked. to continue the break and hold the table. But of course she does have two shots here. She would have liked to pot it, but it's not a bad result. Now it's a question, does she take the easy ball over the pocket and try and take position to get to pot out, or does she play a bit more conservative and defensive, the fact that the black is on the cushion, and try and hope for another two shots somewhere? Quite a dilemma in these situations, particularly when you're playing for the team and you want to try and do the right thing. She's going for the pot at this stage. It's quite good to pot this red in the top right-hand pocket at this end. Time out. Having a good look at that pot. And of course, she's got to bring her white around in order to get onto the other two balls at the other end of the table. And avoid hazards like that. That's a great chance for South Australia. That could be a turning point in the match. It's a massive difference from going 8-11 down to 9-10 down at this stage of the match. Ooh, that's a bit shorter than what she would have liked. It's amazing what pressure does at this time, at this stage. Yeah, she's done that nicely. And South Australia breathe a sigh of relief. And I see, breathe a sigh of relief. In case you don't know, I am South Australian, but I'm trying to be independent. But I think you might have caught on that I was losing a bit of breath there. So South Australia, 9-10. Victoria leading this titanic struggle between these two great sides, two women, great women's sides in Australian April. Star-studded lineups. So Lindo Element is out there again. We've got Carol Harrison on that other table for South Australia. Lindo to break. Just what you don't want. A nice spread, but no pot. And of course, she's playing against the current Australian champion, who earlier on in the day defeated Rhiannon Bolton of Victoria. Lindo has won more Australian titles than any other woman in Australia. So today she made it number 6. On the reds. She has made it to the semi-finals of the Worlds several times. You can never quite break it to make it into the final. It's a nice pot and keeps the break running. Interesting to see if she, I'm sure she'll try and pot this ball or just cover. But a player of Lindell's calibre, she pots it. Depending on what she does with the white, she'll be able to keep this break going and never know what it leads to. There we go, that was a percentage shot. In the terms of in or over, which is quite often what we'd be saying to each other in our local side when we didn't quite back up our potting skills. But that was a more calculated one, I think, by a true professional. Now let's see what Little Element comes up with for Victoria. She's got two balls covered down here. The yellow next to that black, which is not going anywhere. And we're going to try and fine cut this. Now Linda's got a chance to take control here. But on the other table, looks like Rhiannon's got control and could possibly be going game. Unless there's some reds hiding there that I can't see. Lindell Hulley full of concentration. Yeah, around and still going on the other table. Didn't back herself to go out here, and she's just played safely. Maybe she was concerned about the black being not running past into this pocket. It's a game where you always seem to play with a shot that you feel confident about. And Victoria have taken another frame, just two frames away from the match.
30 seconds.
Yes, Rhiannon, she was a runner-up today. Her first time into the ladies' singles final. She just got another frame for Victoria, another valuable frame to put them 11-9 up. Looks like this one's going to turn into a little bit of a tactical battle. Lindell Element trying to play the prevent Lindell Hulley from winning, and hope that something develops where she gets an opportunity somewhere down the track. So Lindell's got to cover all bases and South Australia with the reds would have to be favourites at the moment, but I've seen some of these games turn in a shot. Of course not yes, so as we say, Lindell Element's playing the if I'm not going to win, you're not going to win either. And let's see who makes a mistake first. But Lindell Hulley clearly is the advantage at the moment. It's a question of how and when. Very awkward bridge here. Certainly look like a foul from here. So they're the sort of things that Lindell Element is hoping for, that at the crucial stages she manages to get two shots, gets to promote her balls and takes out the frame. This one's a difficult one at the moment with two pockets covered and that yellow in close to the black and another yellow here on the left on the rail. And I think it would take a big two shots to win the frame from this position. Strange things happen sometimes in this game. Those of you out there that have played it, I'm sure you've been had your frustrations over the years. and your share of luck as well, which is possibly what you need here. A little bit of calculated risk can turn things for you sometimes. Not like that. She's got the pot on the yellow, but she's given two shots to Lyndall Hulley. I guess the only salvation for Lyndall Elliman at the moment is that she's got those two yellows covering the red being potted down in this back right-hand corner. But Lyndall will try and organise something for that. Put some sort of plan in place to... Like that. That was the shot. She was trying to play back onto the yellows and pot the red, and still have two shots to clear the last two balls. But unfortunately, it didn't come off at this stage. So, got to go back to the drawing board and work out another plan. Hope you're enjoying this final. Wherever you are in Australia or the other side of the world, for all you World Apple Pool Federation members out there on the other side of the world, special hello from Joe Fanto, President. I can tell you I'm really enjoy these nationals here this year. It's another strategic shot where she's putting the black ball in her territory. I must admit, I'll be very honest with all you viewers out there, I've started to lose track of how to win these games. But we'll let Lyndall show us, Lyndall Hulley that is. Well, they say picture tells a thousand words.
30 seconds.
Of course, Lyndall Elliman has got the two shots that she wants. And somehow she's got to try and get those two balls that are over on this right top pocket being covered by the red and the black out of there, pot them all, and win the frame. Because, of course, if Victoria win another frame, they really can't lose unless it goes into a playoff. Because 12 frames all will make a playoff where both teams choose five players and it's a race to three frames. This did happen last year and South Australia did win. They are the defending champions, South Australia. Looks like we've got a bit of a timeout here because got Gordon Males there, umpire refereeing on that table. He's also been to the world titles and umpired at the world titles in 2013. We have a few umpires here that have had experience at the world titles. Back to this match, and Lyndall Elliman back to work after that slight timeout, which sometimes gives you a little bit of a breather to relieve a bit of tension and gather your thoughts. That was a nice pot. But of course, the real business is these two balls that are in the black, which are being prevented from going anywhere. And when's the moment that you try and break them out? Maybe she's got something in mind that I haven't thought of. Maybe the viewers might want to write in and let us know. You got to be quick, though.
30 seconds.
Yeah, she's just going for that middle pocket. No. Yes, middle pocket, but the double. She may try and play the black onto the yellow. But then you run the risk that by giving Lindell Hully two shots, she can get the black out and then pot it.
30 seconds.
Very tough game, the sort of game that I never used to like getting into. It's too much thinking for my liking. Yeah, that's what she's done. Played the black onto the yellow, onto the red. Potted Lindell Hully's red and given her two shots. So now the foul two shots, looks like Lindell has nominated a yellow, just in case she hits it first, but she's chosen to play the black first. Of course, as easy as that. That's how you do it. And now the things tighten up a little bit more. South Australia picking up that frame. 11-10 in a race to 13. Victoria need one more frame to reach that magical 12 number, which means that you can't lose in normal frames, but it can be forced into a playoff if it finishes 12-all. Eleven-10 Victoria against South Australia. We've got Renata De La Hunte on that top table. And Renata De La Hunte, of course, is another one of Australia's wonderful ambassadors to women's eight ball. She has made a world final. A few years ago, she was runner-up at the world titles. She's the only Australian woman ever to have achieved that. In modern times. In the earlier days, I understand Natalie Froling, in the early days of our worlds, did make the final. It was a nice break. Young Taylor's back at the table. Taylor Mayer. Young member of the team, but a very composed young lady. Renata's doing battle over there. These two frames are absolutely crucial to everybody. Let's see how it all unfolds. Both South Australians at the table at the moment. And both appear to be in positions where they could either go out or take control. Very exciting part of the match here. And of course, I wouldn't expect any less between these two great sides. I think she was, the way she's looked at that, she tried to just set that up and cover that pocket, trying for a bit of insurance. For later on, the fact that all her balls are not potable. Victoria lead 11-10. And I don't know about you viewers at home, but I'm starting to feel the tension. And I'm sure the players out there are starting to feel the tension. Probably the players at the bench watching more so than the player out there on the table sometimes. Mickey McPherson. Very bubbly young character. Very passionate about her eight ball. And watch her celebration if she wins. Here we go. She'll try and cover. Oh, a bit heavy. That's a bit heavy. I think she's let Taylor in. what's happening on the other table. Taylor pops that ball. She may try and run this yellow across to the top left. The left nearest to us. In your lounge room or wherever you may be watching, or in your offices. Beautiful pot. Now she's really made the break for herself. Looks like Victoria's going out over there, which could take it to the 12 frames, and if that happens, the only way back for South Australia is to force it into a playoff. No! No, and South Australia still can win this outright. Taylor's on her way. So far, so good. Just needs to pot this yellow in this left-hand pocket. Stunned back. I assume that this yellow on the right runs past the red. Must be massive pressure for this young Taylor, but she's not new to it. She's been here before. In this sort of company. And Renata's got to do her business. She's got to pull out all her experience. Looks like Taylor's going to have to try a double of some sort. But I'm not sure where the white's going. I'm sure she'll work it out. Don't think so, but it's a nice result. Unless she's made it very difficult for Mickey to go out here. Mickey McPherson of Victoria. In the meantime, Renata's on the other table. Trying to piece together, potting these remaining balls. Just looking at Renata's table and not quite sure how far that yellow is off the top. In the meantime, Mickey McPherson's doing the business here for Victoria. She's asked for time out because Renata's down getting the rest for this shot. I think this is very potable for Renata, but with the pressure that's hanging over this frame, she should be able to come nicely back for the black here, Renata, which would tie the score up at 11-all if she can do this. Yes, that's a great shot. Great shot, and I think she's come back well enough for the black. Yes, that's very cuttable into the middle. Which then really throws this game totally in the balance. Taylor's snookered here, but she's got a ball over the pocket. I'd say she'll probably run this red down and just try and make it a bit more awkward for the pot out. And South Australia have squared up this match. South Australia, Victoria, 11-all in a race to 13 in this women's team final here at the Australian Eight Ball Pool Federation Championships. What a match. The same tension which we felt last year. All over again. Mickey McPherson. And now all of a sudden, with the way the balls are on this table, you would, I guess, Victoria two shots with six balls on the pocket, and South Australia with one ball on the pocket over a pocket. This game's in the balance. Even if Mickey doesn't pot out, she should be able to keep control. But as you pop more balls and you've got balls on the cushion, the pressure builds. Especially when the score is 11-all in the grand final, playing for an Australian championship and playing for your team to go with it. Always a different pressure playing for your team compared to playing for yourself.
Come on, Joy!
That queuing action is always a little bit smoother when you're just playing for yourself and you haven't got seven or eight other members that you're playing for. Nikki's steady there, she's potted those couple of balls. Still four to go. And the black, of course, to win the match, to win the frame. So we've got Joy Sullivan, who's used to playing these pressure frames. Played many over the years, both at national, international level, and at club level, and at state level. This. Yeah, just tightening up a little bit. She would have liked to go through that a little bit harder and get that red a little bit closer to the pocket, even if she didn't pot it. So now she's going to run this red down, and I'd say she'll probably hope that she doesn't pot it. She'll want to leave a snooker and just promote that red over the pocket. That's it, perfect. And just let Taylor think about this, because every shot that goes by, Mickey's got one less ball on the safe. Well, this is rather daring at this stage of the match, but she's obviously confident that Mickey's not going to go out, but with two shots. Two frames left in the match. The girls must be feeling the tension now. Mickey's taking every second she can take on this shot. And pot this in one, so that she's still got not there, not quite. Margin for error is becoming less and less. The fear of letting Taylor in with a yellow over the pocket. The tension in the queuing action must be building, hence when you go for a snooker, the degree of difficulty tends to increase because you need perfect touch. Looks like at this stage she's going to plant red onto the other red and pot. Yes. Remember, she's only got one shot left. This double comes off, then she's in business. This is the sort of thing that you need to win a Australian championship. Shots like this to come off. She'll be thinking this could be the championship shot. And she's done it. Ooh. What do you say? Slightly unlucky or something she overlooked? And now she's looking to go up the table. Because again, if she pots this red, she'll be on the black. Just a question of what degree of difficulty it'll be depending on where the white finishes. Of course, we've got Joy Sullivan over there, the old battler for South Australia. say that in a kind sense. Just to a lovely lady. And playing great pool. And she has been, has done for many, many years. And this is looking good. Yeah, it's perfect. Played it. Oh, just a little bit unlucky to be left a better angle, but still very potable. Just a little bit more work to do. She would have liked just back a couple of inches so she could put it straight in the middle. Okay, so this black. Now you watch Mickey McPherson if she pots this black. She celebrates like no other lady I've seen before. The tension's mounting. The drum roll's playing as she lines up. Missed by the finest of margins. And now, young Taylor. Queuing over the cushion, but plenty of space. There's room to work the white, to try and give yourself a comfortable position on the black. Ooh, he hasn't done anything with it. Not the sort of shot you want to leave yourself when you're trying to just edge ahead. Still very gettable. Let's see. And South Australia take a 12-11 lead. All of a sudden, South Australia have hit the front at the business end of the match. One frame to go. Either South Australia win the match and become Australian champions, or Victoria win and force a playoff. That is the predicament. And who better would you have at the table than Joy Sullivan for South Australia? Captain of Australia. Played many times for Australia, played for a state, won many Australian titles. Appears to be cool in all situations. Is this the last frame of the match? Or will there be more to come? Hope all you viewers out there are enjoying this, particularly on the other side of the world. It's a reasonable time for you to be watching, and I remind you all that after this, scheduled to start in about 50 minutes time, is the men's team final. It should be very exciting between New South Wales and Victoria. Where it is. What's she thinking? Joy Sullivan at the table for South Australia.
Come on, Joy, come on. Let's go, Joy.
And of course, the umpire is taking pole position. Okay. This is it. Just a few balls left in this frame. With South Australia at the table. South Australia lead 12-11. If it goes 12-all, the match will be drawn and we have a playoff. What a great risky shot. I think that dance is what did it. It got that ball around, moved the black. And of course leave that white, left that white nice and awkward for Karen Winter. South Australia have the edge in this frame. Can Karen pull it off for Victoria and force into a playoff? Heart was in the mouth. Urging that ball to stay out of that middle pocket. It's a great pot. Can't quite see if that black fits behind that yellow. He's going for these reds. Venturing around the table. Wherever the white may fall, pot the deck's red. As they say, if in doubt, pot out. Nice little double. And now she's left this red to run down to this corner, right corner. And she'd be hoping that that black can be played maybe hard into the cushion, back under the yellow and into the pocket. And she's missed. This is a great opportunity now for Joy Sullivan to step up and win it for South Australia. The plant. She's got the pot. Looks like she can play another plant. Yellow onto the yellow. Into the pocket. And then that yellow should sit just between the black and the rail. Perfect. And Joy steps up and looks like she's going to win the winning frame for South Australia. And South Australia will add another championship. The number 11. Joy's getting the bridge, making sure nothing can go wrong here. What better player would you like at the table in these circumstances? Joy Sullivan. She's done it. South Australian women are the 2014 championship. But what a tussle. Once again, an epic match between South Australia and Victoria. Hope you've enjoyed this, viewers. Stay around. Listen to the cheers. They will celebrate well into the night. Hope you've enjoyed this, viewers, but don't go away because in half an hour, the men's team final. This is Joe Fanto signing off for the time being.
Victoria. Linda, you can say a few words for Victoria. Please roll out a round of applause for Linda.
Thank you.